Hello everybody, welcome to another video of the Zero Trust Workshop. Today we're going to talk about the network pillar guidance. My name is Thomas Etzner. I am a product manager as part of the customer experience team, and with me I have my colleague
Andrew Mwathu. I'm a product manager in the Azure Network Security CXC team. So to start us off, let's talk about your role as the networking workshop lead. Well, the roadmap gives us structure. The real value comes from the insights that you'll share. First of all, you are the technology subject matter expert. So an expert in Entra ID, Identity, Secure Service Edge, Azure Networking, and Azure Network Security. This is important so that you can confidently guide customers through the solutions. Secondly, you are a Zero Trust architect, offering best practices for segmentation, threat protection, and securing both ingress and egress network points. Third, you draw on your enterprise networking experience to translate on-premise concepts such as VPNs and DMZs into cloud-native, hub and spoke, and Zero Trust designs. Finally, you act as a facilitator and coach, driving conversation between security, networking, and operations teams so they uncover the critical insights that make their Zero Trust journey a success. So the Zero Trust Workshop Delivery Guide provides a structured approach for delivering Microsoft's Zero Trust Architecture Workshops. It outlines how to assess a customer's current environment, identify security gaps, and recommend actionable projects to strengthen their Zero Trust posture. To run a smooth workshop, it is important to engage the right stakeholders. For example, security, networking, application, and leadership teams, and allocate dedicated time, for example, 2-hour virtual sessions or a single half-day in-person session. For detailed guidance on scheduling, facilitation techniques, and recommended participants, please see the workshop delivery guide at aka.ms/ZT Workshop Delivery Guide. So now I'll hand it over to Thomas, who will take us through the workshop mechanics and the first sections of the new network pillar.
Perfect. Thank you, Andrew. So as you can see here on the screen, this is the overview that you're maybe familiar from the other pillars of the Zero Trust Workshop, and I'll walk you through the ZTNA part, Zero Trust Network Access, as well as the Secure Web Gateway part, and then I'll hand it over back to Andrew to talk about the hybrid part. Now, let's get started. Let's dive right into the first one I want to talk about is the modernization VPN and how do you protect your legacy applications. And that's typically also what we call the ZTNA part. Let's dive right in. So the first one is you see here on the swim lane is how do you enable and how do you transition from a classical VPN setup into a modern identity aware ZTNA based approach. And as you see here, we call out the different phases. We also give an indication of what we believe a potential deployment input is, a deployment effort is, as well as the user impact that you could potentially face either in your environment or in your customer's environment. We also follow that notion of first then next, and you see here, you know, we're ending this swim lane with eventually decommissioning the VPN infrastructure and then also build on top of the SD-WAN capabilities. You see that box has a slightly different color, so that's a call out to a different swim lane, and this is a particular one that Andrew will cover later on his site. Moving on, next one that you want to focus on is the segmentation piece. So you will want to start with, you know, first get an understanding what is the app's usage in your environment or your customer's environment, and define a segmentation strategy. And you always wanted to start first with a macro segmentation, and then you fine-grain that out as you go along. And eventually you achieve a micro segmentation up to a process level. Moving on, next one would be how do you protect your on-premises infrastructure? That's also for us part of the ZTNA pillar because Zero Trust Network Access covers that part as well. And here you see a couple of items that are on the roadmap. First one is the DC agent for a global secure access, as well as the definitions for the policies, and then eventually also implement a local access. The last one is the monitoring pillar or swim lane as part of the ZTNA pillar. Here you see it's a horizontal swim lane that covers the key parts that you will also see in the other swim lanes that we'll talk about. We always wanted to start with, enable the monitoring or leverage what is already in your tenant infrastructure available, focus on the audit logs, and then you can also integrate it either in your existing SIEM solution or export it into a existing SIEM solution, or eventually you leverage the Sentinel integration that's being called out here. Finally, at the end, we want you to, monitor and scale out. You always wanted to start with the project small and starting and scaling out later on. Now, moving on to a secure web gateway, or how do you secure access to all of your internet resources? Here you see the big picture of all the different capabilities. Now, again, let's dive right into, I want to start with the base secure web gateway capability. Similar notion here, you see a couple of building blocks that we want you to focus on. The first one, start with onboarding M365 traffic, and then eventually you will onboard internet access capabilities, and then add more advanced filtering capabilities as you go along. Moving over to how do you further protect M365? We have a couple of new capabilities as part of the offering here called out universal tenant restrictions, as well as signaling for conditional access, which allows you to have richer controls as part of your conditional access integration. Also wanted to cover eventually the B2B scenario. This is currently in private preview, so hopefully soon you will have that in public as well. Moving over to the more advanced secure web gateway capability, the first one as an enabler technology is the TLS inspection. So once you have enabled TLS inspection, you'll be able to dive in deeper into the network filtering controls with network DLP, for example, threat intel filtering, and eventually cloud firewall capabilities. Again, a call out here to the pillars that Andrew will cover, or swim lanes that Andrew will cover, SD-WAN capabilities. So you see there is also intertwining between the different swim lanes and guidance that we've produced for you guys. Moving on, agentless secure web gateway. There may be scenarios where you have network segments where you cannot deploy an agent, or you do not want to deploy an agent. For those scenarios, we have agentless capabilities, and here the first one we wanted to recommend is you start with the M365 traffic, then moving over to leveraging the new network compliant network controls, and then eventually also enable the rest of the internet traffic for those agentless scenarios. Finally, as mentioned in the ZTNA swim lanes, the horizontal swim lane for monitoring, you will see here, quite a similar approach. Start with looking what you have already, audit logs, integrating into your existing or third-party SIEM solution, and then also adding remote network control, network logs if you have enabled them. With that, that brings me over to Andrew.
Thank you very much, Thomas, for that overview. So in this section, it's called the Network and Application Protection and Control. And here we focus on establishing a zero trust perimeter and internal defense for your environment. We achieve this by controlling traffic flows at the edge, segmenting internal networks into least privileged zones, layering in advanced threat protection at both the network and application layers, and finally implementing centralized monitoring and automation to surface and respond to security events in real time. This section is divided into five main areas, and we'll now take a brief look at each. So first, we start with protecting our public endpoints. So this swim lane is all about identifying and protecting our public endpoints using Azure DDoS protection, and then we validate readiness through simulated attacks. At the end of this swim lane, you see we have automation and governance, and that is where we now leverage inbuilt governance tools such as Azure Policy for us to enforce governance and ensure that this solution is working. In the second section, this is about the network access control. And here we are controlling network traffic flows by deploying an Azure firewall and enforcing strict network and application rules to control and secure traffic flows. So here it's all about controlling the traffic and ensuring that you're filtering and only allowing secure and identified traffic that we know about. In the third section, this swim lane is on network segmentation. And here we are deploying a centralized Azure firewall in a hub and spoke topology, where we leverage network and application rules to segment traffic securely between internal resources. So this helps us to reduce the blast radius in the event that there is an attack, as all traffic from segments is being filtered through a central control point. In the fourth section, we have the network and application threat protection. Here, we're enabling the threat protection capabilities of our solutions proactively to detect, block, and respond to malicious activity across the network and application layers. We enable the threat protection capabilities of our firewall, such as threat intelligence, intrusion detection and prevention, as well as TLS inspection to filter encrypted traffic. We also enable web application firewall with managed and custom rules to protect against web threats and vulnerabilities. Finally, we have monitoring, and this is where we bring in together visibility and logs from all of these solutions for us to be able to know what is happening within our network. So here you'll see, as in the previous monitoring that Thomas had shared, we're leveraging the existing inbuilt logging capabilities. We're also able to leverage integrated workbooks for visibility, export logs into SIEM, and also be able to automate incident responses and using automation as well as integration with artificial intelligence systems such as Security Copilot for rapid threat mitigation. Great. So having taken a look at the new networking pillar, having seen an overview of the swim lanes, we are now ready to start on your workshop journey on this new network pillar. So once you've delivered this workshop, as you wrap up, it's important for us to go through some of some key points that will enable you to have a successful closure. So during this closure, it's usually good to have a closure meeting, ideally with leadership present, so that they can review what you've accomplished and also set a clear path forward. Begin by sharing the completed roadmap spreadsheet with the customer, then summarize the big picture. Highlight the strengths and progress to date and identify the top 3 to 5 initiatives they should prioritize next. Capture any feedback on the session's content and delivery. Finally, clarify follow-up actions. Outline future Zero Trust workshops or additional projects that align with their roadmap and discuss the next steps for engagement with your team. So great, thank you for watching. That's all for this video. Please check out the other videos in this series to learn about the other pillars. We hope you found this session valuable, and thank you once again for watching.
Thank you, everybody.